Yesterday, I got a chance to spend some time with a family recovering from the attack in Boston, really an entire family. Kevin White and his mother, Mary Jo, both suffered injuries from the blast. They were just feet away from the first explosion. Bill White, the husband, the father, is a Vietnam War veteran who received a Purple Heart for his service in Vietnam, but it was Boston where he lost his leg. He remains in the hospital this morning, but this is not a family that is about to let their experience dictate their lives. Listen.
On my arm, this is where they pulled out the biggest chunk of shrapnel right there. And then I have all of these little BB marks all up and down here and all over here. This is all, you see all these round welts. And then over on this side, there's more of them. And then there's all up through here. This is where I got really hit the hardest. So it's interesting because when I went to the hospital, some of these, they actually had the round pieces of metal in them that looked like BBs, basically. I'll always have them to remember, I guess, you know.
Some memory.
Yeah.
So 2:50 p.m. in the afternoon, yep, on Marathon Monday, mm-hmm, what happens?
Well, you know, from what I recall, we were close to the finish line and kind of meandering, stopping, starting, stopping, starting. And suddenly there was this loud explosion, which to me sounded very metallic and almost like had an echo to it. And I saw a huge flash of light, blinding, and then just dark.
This is a picture, yes, of right after the race. Show me where you are.
I am right here. I kind of got blown away from the blast by about 5 feet. And my father is in the red right here laying down. And my mother is right next to him, over him, and you can see that the blast happened right around there.
Mary Jo, I have to say, it had to be terrifying.
The sound was just unbelievable. Yeah. That was
it was just
chaos, like you were in another world.
And then the uncertainty, not knowing for hours.
Yeah.
That was the hardest part, I think, was, you know, not knowing where they were and calling around and trying to find updates and just being kind of helpless and powerless to that. That was difficult.
The explosion goes off, and what happened to you?
It was the explosion, and our clothes were torn off, and yeah, I could not find Kevin at all. My husband, Bill, was on the ground next to me, but I didn't know where Kevin was, and I couldn't see him.
This was in your...
In my purse.
In your purse? And what happened here?
Yes, I won't be making any checks.
Bounced a check.
Just a piece of shrapnel right through it?
Yeah.
You have broken wrist?
I have a shrapnel in my left leg and arm, and it was in my face, and just a small break in one of my hands.
Tell me about your husband.
He's doing remarkably well.
He's in good spirits, given his condition, and health-wise, the doctors are astounded at the progress he's made.
After everything that's happened, are you bitter at all? Angry?
I'm not really. It's one of those things that it was so unpredictable in that it happened that, you know, 1 minute earlier, 1 minute later, it might not have happened. So it's hard to, I'm speaking for myself. I mean, obviously my father, his condition is much, you know, more serious, but I don't sense that he's very bitter or angry.
You?
No, I don't think we're bitter. I mean, that's not the way we live. And, I think it's just a new day and we have new choices to make.
When you see the pictures of these two young men, these brothers, mm-hmm, you winced. Is it hard for you?
I just think, how did that happen to them? You know, how did they get so indoctrinated in something that they would think nothing of destroying so many lives?
If you could say one thing to this 19-year-old kid, what would it be?
I guess, you know, I would say for our family that, we're going to continue on.
Will you ever go back and watch the marathon again?
I would think so, over time.
Maybe, yeah, from a distance. Probably not from the same spot.
Right, right. You know. Maybe a Natick will watch it.
No, I think we will definitely go back. It's not going to stop us from enjoying our life.